Do you want to know how to make your own DIY electronic piano circuit? Hey guys! In this video, I'll show you how to make an electronic piano using the 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 2 alligator clips, 13 jumper wires, 1 5,000 ohms resistor, 7 1,000 ohm resistors, 1 0.1 microfarad capacitor, 1 10 microfarad capacitor, 1 555 timer IC, 7 latch switches, 4 AA batteries for the power source, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode: monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. Put the IC in the lower half of the breadboard, since the upper half is used for the switches. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Pins 1 and 2 are wired together. Pins 3 and 4 are wired together. The switching action happens between these pairs of pins. On the bottom of the switch, you can see the ends of the wires are slightly bent inward. Insert the switch in the middle of the breadboard. If you place this switch in the center of the breadboard, it will only work if pins 1 and 2 are aligned horizontally. Turn the breadboard to the side. Bend the ends of a 1,000 ohms resistor. Insert the 1,000 ohms resistor to pin 7 or discharge and pin 8 or VCC. Insert a jumper wire from pin 6 or threshold to the closest leg of the switch. Bend the ends of a 5,000 ohms resistor. Insert the 5,000 ohms resistor to pin 7, or discharge and the farthest leg of the switch. Insert another switch in the middle of the breadboard. If you place the switch in the middle of the breadboard, pins 1 and 2 must be in the same row. Flipping it the other way won't work because the wires won't reach the holes. I spaced the switches about 3 holes apart, but you can adjust the spacing however you like. Insert a jumper wire from the nearest leg of the first switch to the nearest leg of the second switch. bend the ends of a 1000 ohms resistor. Insert the 1000 ohm resistor between the outermost legs of both switches. The steps for the rest of the switches are going to repeat. A jumper wire connects the left leg of the left switch to the left leg of the right switch. A 1000 ohm resistor connects the right leg of the left switch to the right leg of the right switch. Since the resistors are close together, make sure they don't touch. Keep the wires bent and spaced apart to prevent contact, as touching resistors can cause unpredictable circuit behavior. Turn the breadboard to the other side. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor into pin 3, or output, and the other leg a few rows above the 555 timer. Insert the longer leg into pin 3. Insert a 0.1 microfarad capacitor into pin 2, or trigger in the negative rail. Insert the shorter leg into the negative rail. Turn the breadboard to the other side. Insert a jumper wire into pin 1 or ground. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the 10 microfarad capacitor. Turn the breadboard to the other side. Attach a black alligator clip to the jumper wire that is connected to pin 1 or ground. Attach a red alligator clip to the other jumper wire. Attach the black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the 5-watt speaker. Attach the red alligator clip to the positive terminal. It's time to connect the power supply. Attach the negative lead from the battery holder to the negative rail. Attach the positive lead from the battery holder to the positive rail. Each switch produces a different sound. The left switch produces the lowest pitch, while the right switch produces the highest. We have successfully completed the circuit. Thank you. You're too kind. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This schematic represents a simple electronic piano using a 555 timer IC in a stable mode configuration. The circuit generates different frequencies based on which switch is pressed, producing different tones through a connected 5-watt speaker. A series of 1000 ohms resistors and a 5000 ohms resistor form a voltage divider. Each switch is connected in parallel to a capacitor and is used to select different resistance values. When a switch is pressed, it alters the resistance in the circuit, changing the oscillation frequency of the 555 timer. The 555 timer generates a continuous square wave signal at its output, or pin 3. The frequency of this signal depends on the resistor-capacitor network. The circuit's resistance changes when different switches are pressed, adjusting the timer's oscillation frequency. The 0.1 microfarad capacitor connected between pin 2 and ground helps to stabilize the circuit and avoid false triggering. The 10 microfarad capacitor connected to pin 3 or output transmits the signal to the speaker while blocking DC voltage. It ensures only AC variations or the audio signal reach the speaker. When the 555 timer oscillates, it sends a varying square wave signal through the capacitor to the speaker. The speaker converts the square wave signal into sound waves, producing different tones based on the switch pressed. I hope this video has shown you how to make an electronic piano with a 555 timer IC. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.